Hello everyone, thank you for tuning in. Tilly Burn Light here, coming to you straight from the sunny land of Portugal. Topic of today's video is 18, made by one Ludiorum and currently available on Game Jolt for the low, low price of absolutely nothing or your regional equivalent. If, again, my sound sounds differently, it is because I'm trying out a new recording setup. The microphone is exactly the same, but I have propped up the microphone so that the recording bit actually is in front of my head and in front of my mouth, and I did this via the applied use of a cornflake cereal bowl and several psychology handbooks, not sponsored by the APA, not sponsored by Cornflakes. Again, I do not know what this game is about. I am not sure if it is meant for me to see my mouth. Ooh. Why am I hearing a car horn? Okay, first of all, I'm not going to go where the game expects me to go. I am going to go elsewhere. Oh, is this a segment of the wall only during spring? Jesus, this is confusing. Oh, perspective is a tad bit shot. I'm not sure where the horizon is because there's no point of reference. I'm not sure where the horizon is. It looks like the horizon is very close, but it could be that the horizon is very far away. I'm not sure. Okay, this is weird. Is the horizon here? It's a sea. Oh, this is wonderful. This is pretty. Can I go down? Okay, I'm not gonna go down. I might just crash the game, and then things are gonna go badly. Oh, so this is a seaside thing. That explains the lighthouse over there. Oh, that's nice. It's actually nice. You know, one of my favorite things I've always wanted to repeat. I've done it once, but I've always wanted to repeat it. Is I wanted to go to a cliff by the sea, and I just want to sit down, and I just want to look out into the ocean. I've done that once. It is a magical experience, and I would very much like to repeat it. But it appears that I am at some sort of seaside fort. We have those in Portugal a lot, actually. I even went to one of my cousin's wedding at a seaside fort that was once used as an actual military fort. We have those in Portugal a lot. Or maybe this is just a random rock formation that looks like a castle gate. Who knows? However, I want to see if I can go... I can't go. Ah, yeah, it's an invisible wall. I can't go there. Yeah, I can't go there. Pretty sure that this is not... I'm not supposed to see my mouse, but unfortunately, well, there's nothing I can do about that, but... Whatever. I kind of have to check if the recording software is picking up this fucking game window, so there's not much I can do about the whole thing. Alright. Can I go here? Can I jump? I can't jump. And I can't... Okay, I have to go through the door. It's fine. I can go through the door. Keep forgetting to set up my goddamn cell phone to see just how long I've been recording. Alright. Come on. You know, the game does actually look very nice. It looks a tad bit blocky, but, the aesthetic is pleasantly calming. Okay, so I'm assuming that... Ooh. Can I pick it up? Oh, I just had the most wonderful ASMR experience. Oh, it was like a wave of calm just went through my body as I picked up the flower and the music swelled. And the wind is blowing through the grass, and you can see the grass all move as one as the wind goes through it. Oh, this is a wonderful calming experience. I really wish it could be here. Oh, this is amazing. Okay, I don't know what you can get from the recording, but... It most certainly is not going it's not going to do it justice. Get this game. Get this game right now from Game Jolt. This is actually really nice. This is really nice. I love it. Oh, I love it. What's that? It's a cloud. It's a cloud of darkness. Maybe it's going to rain. And if it rains, then we'll get the wet grass smell. I love wet grass smell after rain. It's beautiful. All right, again, another flower. Oh, and the music swells up. Oh, but the dark cloudiness is getting bigger too. Oh, that's not good. Is it gonna rain? Who knows? But if it is going to rain, it's not bad. And you know why? Because rain is good. Rain cleanses. Rain is awesome. Have you ever been on a grassy plain after it's rained? The smell is divine. Absolutely divine. And look, there's a little boat. There's a little boat that's been abandoned for quite some time. And this is untouched by man. Untouched by man. Oh? Hold on. Hold on for a moment. I'm pretty sure that the statue had more well-defined features. Or maybe it was just me, I'm pretty sure the statue had more well-defined features, or had a more prominent nose, or maybe that was just me. Maybe? I'm pretty sure it did. Okay, hold on. Where's the next flower? I can see the flowers are signaled by these pillars of light. And I wonder, why exactly is it there? Why is that a dark mass? Okay, let's get... The music is very calming. It's raining! It's raining! That changed again. Whoa! Oh, that is beautiful. That is beautiful. That is beautiful. Okay, so... Yeah, it was just me. It was just me. The statue did not actually have well-defined features. It was just me. Okay. But look, it's beautiful. Look at it. Have you ever been by the seaside next to a lighthouse when it's fully functional? It's just as majestic as this. I'm trying to put the mouse out of the screen, but I can't. Oh, I can smell it now. I can smell the wet grass smell. I can smell it now. Oh, and it's beautiful, and I love it. Whoa, fog. Oh, no. Oh, my computer's not going to like this. Oh, it's a bit too much. Okay, I think I found a way. Okay. I found a way through the thick underbrush. There we go. I cannot tell you how soothing this is. The music is so good. It's very simple music. It's just a couple of notes, but it's so soothing. It's like a wave of calm going through your entire body. And I cannot help but feel a lot better about everything. It's like I'm receiving a pleasant massage. Only instead of being on my back, it's on my prefrontal lobe. Ah. Prefrontal lobe massages. I love those. Have you tried those? Those are great. You should get more. Oh, whoop. Sorry about that. You should get a few frontal lobe massages. Those are great. Okay, so I'm assuming I have to go through. And again, it's not really what you would call high fidelity graphics, but does it really matter? Look at it. You can see the sun go through the black clouds. You can see the rain. You can see the lighthouse. You can hear the music, and you can practically smell the grass. Oh no, I missed a flower. See, this is the problem. It's really hard to navigate in a forest, especially when you have fog that just mysteriously shows up from nowhere. But I'm not going to say anything bad about that, because it's magical. And it even mutes the rain. Listen to it. Okay, it doesn't get the rain, but you get the point. Oh, it stopped raining! Oh, it's a nice warm fire. It's a nice warm cozy fire in the woods. Enough that you could probably roast some marshmallows and tell stories around it about that one time you went to Old Man Jenkins' house and things happened, and then there were ghosts. There were ghosts in Old Man Jenkins' house, and Jenkins was one of them all along. Ah, soothing. It is an ASMR-like experience, and I love it. I absolutely adore it. You know, when I picked this up on Game Jolt, I wasn't expecting it to be this good. And it is. It's really good. I wasn't expecting it to be this good. I'm probably popping the microphone a lot because I'm really close to it, but I don't care. It's so good. Okay, so I'm out of the forest. Okay. and it seems like the dark clouds are receding. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Dark clouds are receding. It's nice. This is kind of like Dear Esther. I'm pretty sure there is no failure state, so I wouldn't call this a game so much as I would call it an art installation. And you know what? That's not me diminishing it. Art installations can be very, very pleasurable. Have you been to an art installation? Art installations are nice. They're very nice. It looks so far away, doesn't it? It looks so far away that from when we started. And it hasn't even been that long, and it looks so far away. Now look, there's another statue there. And there's another tree like the one in the beginning. But where? Where? Where's the flowers? Where are the flowers? I want to know where the flowers are. The colors of the sky are really pretty. That's all I can say. They're really pretty. It's beautiful. It's a visually stunning experience and a musically stunning experience, an auditory, musically stunning experience as well. It's, again, a very simple song, very simple music, but it's so soothing. It's so good in your ears. I might just actually, after I'm done with this, you know, not just actually, I'm actually going to do it. I will, after finishing the recording, put this on full blast because, believe it or not, this is actually, oh god, I'm overusing actually again. This is on very low volume on my computer because I have to put everything I record at, say, volume 5 or everything else at volume 30. Otherwise, it gets too loud. But I will, in fact, put this on full volume and then I will appreciate the experience. And it seems as if, whoa, what is this? Is this a volcano? It is a volcano. Why would you put a lighthouse near a volcano? That sounds very, very dangerous. Ah. And you even have these purple particle effects. It's so nice. Oh, and you have the undulating air thing, which is just, you know, a mirage and a visual effect, but look at it. You have the undulating air thing. Games with much bigger budgets don't even do that, and this game does. Nice attention to detail right there. I have to say I love it. I really do. It's undulating air. I love this effect. Even in real life, whenever I do get the experience, I absolutely adore it. Oh, it's so cool. It's so cool. It's so cool. It's so cool. We're so high. It's so cool. We're so high and it's so cool and it's so awesome. I love it. Oh, I'm fanboying all over this, but you know what? It's so cool. Oh, I love it. Oh, this reminds me of the one time when I went on vacation for like a week in a hilly area called Jerez or Jerez in my country. And one of the first things we did was climb one of the hills. And the hills are really high. It's like 500 meters up. And at the top, after climbing through these very narrow stone and dirt trails, you'd be at the top of the hill and you would see everything around you. And it'd be just a collection of hills as far as the eye could see. And it was majestic. And I even saw two condors fly beneath me and an eagle. Oh, good memories. This game is evoking good memories. My hippocampus is being thoroughly stroked, and I love it. It's my hippocampus is being cuddled, and I absolutely adore that. Thank you, game, for cuddling my hippocampus. Oh, another statue. Okay. And I knew it. I was going to the lighthouse. I knew it. I was going to the lighthouse. Okay. Oh, it's blackness. Oh, I can't go anywhere else. Do I have to go in? Whoa. Whoa. The hell? It's a calendar. Oh, well, this just took a dark turn. A phone? A phone. At certain moments of lucidity, the mechanical aspect of their gestures, their meaningless pantomime, makes silly everything that surrounds them. A man is ticking on the telephone behind a glass partition. You cannot hear him, but you see his incomprehensible dumb show. You wonder why he is alive. Albert Camus. I think that's a writer. I think Camus is a writer, but I never actually got to read anything by him. Do I go out now? Okay, that was... Okay, so there's no way up. There's no way up. There's no way up to the lighthouse. But the rest is still there. What did that mean? I'm assuming that I kind of need to know the context of that quote to fully get what I'm trying to say, but perhaps the intention of it, it was to indicate the passage of time? Maybe? I don't know. I'm actually confused now. And I'm overusing the word actually, and I'm very sorry for that. I don't mean to overuse the word actually. This looks different somehow. I don't know why. This looks very different somehow. Very different. This wasn't the way that I took, is it? This isn't the way that I took. It isn't, I think. I don't think it is. I may be wrong, but it doesn't look like the way I took before. Did the game world change? The hell? Okay. That's a bit weird. Okay. For whatever reason, I'm not hearing bongos. Okay, whatever. Sweet bongos, whatever. Okay. But what was the point of the quote? Oh, boy. Oh, no. Oh, okay. Oh, thank God. Okay. I thought I was going to fall down. But what was the point of the quote? I believe that Albert Camus is a French writer. I've never read anything by him. I may be wrong, but I think he is a French writer, and I never read anything by him. I'm assuming that I sort of need to know the context of the quote to fully understand it. Wait, hold on. Oh, no. Oh, boy. Oh, no. Oh, God damn it. Come on. Oh, I can't move. Oh, I can't move. Oh, I can't move. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no, I'm stuck. Ah, damn it. Oh, I'm going to have to start over again. Oh, no. Okay, I'm going to have to start over. I'll be right back. I think. I'll be right back. All right, and we're back. I'm hoping this is on. It's on. Now, I've had the opportunity first to go through the entire game with the sound really high. I didn't put the sound back down. I heard it high. And let me tell you, it is just as magical and amazing as I hoped it would be. And I also took some time to read through what appeared on the screen, the quote by Camus. I may be completely wrong, but what I took out of it was, I don't know, some sort of rumination on the meaning of life. In that we go about our day in our mechanical automatization, we see everyone go about their day with their own little repeated gestures, their mechanical gestures, everything we do that we take for granted and we just consider normal. And in certain moments of lucidity, we have to stop and wonder, why is it that way? Why do people do things that way? Why do we do this? Why are we here? Why do we do the things we do? And why do we do them in the way that we do? Maybe that's the point. Maybe that's what the quote is about. But now, I'm pretty sure that this is the only way down. So why exactly does it end in a dead end? And I'm assuming that that quote, when allied with, you know, the whole calendar thing underneath my feet, the fact that the further ahead I go into the phone box, the calendar behind me falls into the dark abyss, I'm assuming that that is some sort of metaphor on the passage of life. That we go through life automatically, on autopilot on most things. We take things for granted, or we do things because we've always done things. It's automatic now. It's mechanical. We don't consider why we do the things that we do. We don't look around us and wonder, why exactly am I doing this the way that I am doing it? Why am I even doing it in the first place? And we don't really think about that. If you think about it right now, we don't think about it. Because it's not good for us. It's not good for us to decompose and deconstruct everything that we do. So we just go on autopilot most of the time. And I'm assuming, I may be completely wrong, but I'm assuming that is the point of the quote. To deconstruct this. To point out the inherent absurdity of it. That this is, all in all, a pantomime that we go about our lives, day in, day in, day in, until eventually, in a few certain rare moments of lucidity, oh, it's this way down. Oh, okay, this way down. Okay. That in certain moments of lucidity, we can look at it and think, this is absurd. But then we go back to our lives. I wonder if there's even anything down there, because the game is now eerily silent. There's no music. After you leave the lighthouse, when you leave the lighthouse after you enter it, there's no music. There's no nothing. You still have the wavy air. That's good. I still like that. It's thought-provoking in a way. It really is. And not in the pseudo-intellectual way, because it's easy to be pseudo-intellectually thought-provoking, even though I doubt that you can be thought-provoking while being pseudo-intellectual. But it does require, it is a bit of a realization. It's a moment of insight, you know? It's a moment of insight. It doesn't point out the truth. That's the main difference between being pseudo-intellectual thought-provoking and being intellectually thought-provoking. A pseudo-intellectual will point out things to you. An actual intellectual will phrase their thoughts in such a way that they will leave you wondering, what exactly does that person mean? And I'm pretty sure that these statues are changing shape. Maybe completely wrong. An intellectual will leave you wondering, what exactly did that person mean? And that is what I think that quote is all about. Perhaps I'm completely wrong. Perhaps that is not what the quote is about. But ultimately, the thought maybe is to provoke your thought. It's to poke your brain and tell it, think. What does this quote mean to you? What does it make you think about? And honestly, the result may be a valid quote. A completely valid quote. Did these trees get bigger? I think these trees just got bigger. Maybe? I'm not sure. Maybe the passage of time did occur. Maybe I did pass time. Again, I may be completely wrong, but it does look like these trees are bigger now than they were before when I first came in. And I'm pretty sure that the statues are getting different, eroded. I hear something. Oh? There's something there. Did this statue change too? No, it's still like this. I think. But hold on. What happens if I go really far back? Because I remember that when I first came in... Oh, it's closed now. Oh, there's no going back. There's no going back to where you started. It's all forward now. But the statue is changed, because when you first come in, the statue is well-defined. You can see everything. The eyes, the mouth, the nose. But now it's eroded. You can barely make out any features at all. So it is. It is the passage of time. As you go forward, time goes by. And maybe that's symbolic of your birth. I don't know. Maybe that is symbolic of your birth. You burst forth through the gate. The metaphor is not lost on me. And from thenceforth, the gate is closed. There's no going back to where you were before. Okay, so I have to go down there? How do I go down there? Is there a way to go down? Is there a ramp? Oh, there's a way down there. Oh, do I have to go all the way up? Oh, I have to go all the way up. Oh, no. Oh, I have to go all the way up there again? Oh, okay, I'm so sorry. Oh, I'm so sorry. I don't know why I'm apologizing, but I am. I am so sorry. I didn't mean for it to be that way. I didn't want to waste your time. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. Why am I apologizing? I don't know. But I'm so confused right now. But it's an experience. Assuming, of course, I got the metaphor correct. And assuming, I'm guessing that there's something in the description of the game that tells you what this game is about. I'm sure. And it's going to be something completely different. The metaphor is going to be completely different. And I'm just going to be interpreting this far beyond what it's meant to be interpreted. But maybe that is what the point of the game is. This is the passage of time. As you go forward, there's no going back now. Things just keep going on without you. It doesn't really matter how much you don't want that to happen. It is going to happen. And as you go forward, the days, the weeks, the months, the years, you just fall into the abyss. And there's no way but forward through the flow of time. I'm a bit lost now. I think the hill towards the lighthouse is somewhere around here. Ah, here we go. There we go. Or not. It appears that I have actually managed to do myself a small lap around the forest, which, mind you, is excruciatingly easy to do if you don't know how to navigate, especially in low light and low visibility conditions such as these. As it turns out, yes, navigating through a forest without any sort of navigational equipment is actually very hard. Very easy to go around in circles, as I, many others, including the Mythbusters, just demonstrated. Oh, this is beautiful. It's beautiful and thought-provoking. I like that in the game. Okay, it's here. It's here. I have to go this way, I think. I have to go this way. It's this way. I think it's this way. Okay, well, hold on. A bit too thick. Too many trees. It's a bit hard to get into the trees now. Hold on. Oh, God damn it. Okay, so I have to go through to the other side. I have to go to the other side of the rock upon which the lighthouse is built to get down to where the last beam of light is. This is surprisingly more difficult than it was the first time around. So I have to go all the way to the other side. So I'm assuming that I have to take the other path that leads out of the lighthouse. But when I took that path out of the lighthouse, then I ended up in a dead end. And I had to start all over because I was stuck on the geometry of the game. So how does that work? Maybe I have to go here. Not here, but here. Maybe there's a way there. Maybe? Oh, no, there's not. There isn't a way through here. There's no way through here. I have to find my way. And the way is the way that life provides. Why? I'm waxing philosophical here for a moment, and I'm very sorry, but again, suddenly there's no song, there's no music, there's no nothing. You go into the lighthouse, you realize the absurdity that is going through life mechanically and automatically and on autopilot. Camus, the quote, provoked you into thinking about the nature of what reality is. Yeah, I'm assuming there is no sound, but then again, my headphones have been a bit on the fritz lately, so it's entirely possible that I completely missed the sound. Then again, no, because I heard the sound emitted by the pillar of light next to the boat. So there is sound. But there's no music. It's just deadly silent. So I wonder what exactly is going to happen. I don't know. I may wonder. I may consider. I may ruminate on what is the nature of this game and what is the nature of everything that's going to be, presented to me. I don't know. That's the point. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. And this game has me gripped. Gripped in its claws, in a way. I go in. I experience epiphany. I come out. And I go down this way. And I know that some way, in some way, I have to go down this way in order to get to the last pillar of light. Because there is a gray path leading down from the rock upon which the lighthouse is built that goes down to where the boat is and where the last pillar of light is. And perhaps, much like the boat has reached its end, the end of its life, as it crashed onto the beach and is now destroyed and completely covered in sand, so too am I walking towards my end, not just the end of this game, not just the end of the experience of this game, but also metaphorically my end, the end of my life experience, the end of my life. I looked at a man in a telephone box, and I had an epiphany on the nature of reality. And now, I happily and content walk towards the end of it all. I think I can hear the waves. I think I can hear the waves. Follow the gray path. So that's why I made my mistake. It was a bit jagged, but it was there. It was there. Yeah, it was there. I just had to keep going down this way. Okay. I go down into the beach. Ah, the sound of waves. I think that was the sound of waves. It is. Have you ever heard waves? For those of you who haven't, you really do have to hear waves. Go to the ocean. On vacation. Go hear the waves. It's worth it. Come on. Oh, my headphones were fucked. Hold on. Oh, my headphones are a bit jacked. Hold on. Yeah, hold on. See, I have a problem here, which is the fact that my headphones are a bit screwed up, and it's really hard to get them to do some... ouch! There goes a laptop. It's a bit hard to get them to get their sound up properly. There we go. What happens now? That was wonderful. That was absolutely wonderful. Thank you all for tuning in. I hope you guys and gals had a great time. As always, I'm open to suggestions in the comment section down below. And until next we meet, this is Tullius P. Burnlot, signing off. Goodbye.